Welcome to my new video about XML. Before watching this video, please make sure you watch the XML introduction video. You can find the link in the video description. Let's go. I showed you in the first video the following parts of XML. Now I will explain these parts one by one in UiPath, how to use, and which methods and properties has each one of them. Let's start with document. Document part called in UiPath, XDocument. The type of this one is, System.xml.link.xDocument. System.xml.link is a namespace and contains the classes for link to XML. The next one is element. It's called XElement in UiPath. And has this type. Attribute is called XAttribute and has the following type. Comment is called XComment and has the following type. Text is called XText and has the following type. How to create a variable from any type of them? Let's see. First you create a variable in UiPath, then you can search for the type. Here you get the following window. If you write the namespace, you will see all variable types for XML. We will use only these five. So now you know, which type has each part and how to find it. Let's now go through these parts one by one, and explain the most important methods and properties of them. Let's begin with XDocument. XDocument has two methods to read XML document. These are load and parse. If your XML document is in file, and you want to get the XML from this file, then you need to use load. Load reads the XML string and parse it. That means, this method converts the XML file to readable code. If your XML is stored in a string, then you need to use the parse method. This is also the same as before. It converts your XML string to readable code. So these two methods are to read XML. But we also need to read certain information from XML. For this we have another methods and properties. Let's see them. I have here my XML document from the first video. As I mentioned in the first video, each XML document could have declaration. To read it, we can use the function, declaration. We will get this row as output. As already mentioned, each XML document must have one root element. Only one root element is allowed. We can also read this root element using the function root. We will get the following as output. Or we can also read only the root element name using this function. We will get the following as output. As you know, XML consists of elements. To read an element from the document, we can use the function elements with the element name to get the element. For example, if we want to get the root element, we can set the following. But if we want to get the next element, we have to set the following. As you can see, we should write the names of each parent element. This will be very difficult if we want to get the city name element, for example. We have to write the following. This is too much, therefore we have another function to get the elements without writing each parent element. This function called descendants. For example, if I want to get the city name element, I can use only the document variable with this function, and then the function elements with the element name, city name. These are the most important functions for the XML document. Let's switch to UiPath to show you how to use these functions in UiPath, and which output we will get. First we have to create a variable for the XML document. As I mentioned before, the type for document is system.xml.link.xDocument. Here is my XML document. It's saved in a file, therefore I will use the method load. This method needs the XML file path as input. Let's copy the file path. So I will write the XML file path here. I will add write line activity to print the XML document to the console to check if it works. I will run the code to see the result. As you can see, we have the XML document here. Now let's move to the next function. I want to read the declaration of the XML document. As I already mentioned, we can use the function declaration. Add write line activity to print the declaration to the console. Write this one to get the declaration. I will disable this write line activity because I don't need it anymore. Let's run the code to see the result. As you can see, we have here the declaration. The next property is the root element. I will show you how to get the root element completely. And also the name of the root element. First, let's add write line activity to print the root element. Write the following. Add another write line activity to print the root element name. Write the following. I will disable this write line activity because I don't need it anymore. Now let's run the code to see the result. As you can see, we have first the root element. Root element contains also child elements. All these elements are part of the root element. We have also here the root element name. I will show you the functions, elements and descendants later in this video. Let's move to the next one, XElement. As you know, XML consists of elements. Element could have attributes. If we want to get one attribute, we can use the function, attribute. Using this function we get an attribute. But if we want to get all attributes of the element, we can use the function, attributes. We can also check, if an element has attributes using this property. Or we can also get the first or last attribute using these properties. We can also check if the element has child elements using this property. We can also get the element value using the property value. We can also use the function setElementValue to set a new value for the element. Or also the function setAttributeValue to set a new value for an attribute. We can also get the child elements of the element using these functions. Element function return one element, but elements function return all child elements of the current element. As you can see, we have many functions and properties for an element. I will show you some of these in UiPath. First, I will disable this sequence because I don't need it anymore. Now I will create a variable for the elements. I will use the type collection XElement because I want to get more than one element. We can select this type as follows. As I mentioned before, to get child elements, we need to use one of these two functions, elements or descendants. As I mentioned before, descendants is easier to use, therefore I will use it. Let's get all customer elements. To do that, I will write the following. So we have all customer elements in this variable. I want to go through all elements and get some information, therefore I will add for each loop. As you know, this collection contains different elements. These elements are of type XElement. Therefore, I will change the type argument to XElement. First, I want to get the value of each element. To do this, I will write the following in write line activity. Now I want to check if this element has child elements. And now I want to check if the element has attributes. Now let's read the value of attribute ID. I will write some text before each one of these write line activities, to make it more clear in the console. I will run the code to see the result. As you can see, we have the data from the XML document. You can see that we have the value for all child elements of element customer, because customer element doesn't have a value. But if we want to get the value of only the name element, we have to define it here so. Let's run the code again. As you can see, we have now only the value of element name. Now let's move to the next part. It's XAttribute. If we want to get the value of the attribute, we can use the following property. We can also get the attribute name using this property. Or we can also get the next or previous attribute using these properties. We can also change the value of the attribute using this function. Let's switch to UiPath to implement these methods and properties there. First, I will disable this sequence because I don't need it anymore. I will create a variable for the attributes. This should be of type collection XAttribute. We can do that as follows. Now write the following to get all attributes of element customer. So we have all attributes in the collection. I want to go through these attributes and calculate some information, therefore I will add for each loop. First change the type argument to XAttribute, because each element in the collection is from type XAttribute. First I want to read the attribute name. And now I want to read the attribute value. Let's run the code to see the result. As you can see, we have here all attribute names and values from the XML document. So this was a briefly introduction for XML and UiPath, how to read the different parts from XML document. My example was too short and easy, but normally we have long and more complicated XML documents. To read the data from them is not easy and takes long time, therefore you have two options to get the data. You can use the UiPath activities with if conditions and loops etc. Or you can use Linq queries, which is easier to create and more performant. You want to learn Linq queries in context of XML? Then wait for the new video on my channel. You will learn everything you need to get started with Linq and XML. And now before ending this video, please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, if you like my way to explain the different topics. You can also help me if you share the content with your friends. Stay safe.